Hello everybody, and welcome to a restarted Let's Play of Supreme Lord 2020 as Poland in the Blitzkrieg scenario. As I'm sure you may know, my Eastern Siberia LP that I somehow forgot to save. Same thing here, that I for some reason also forgot to save this, and so on and so forth. Also to one user, I understand of the idea to just outright declare war on Germany, just head straight to the capital of Berlin, but I'm not gonna do that now. I'm gonna probably do that sometime if I survive or get conquered, then I'll start over again and see what would happen if we just go to war immediately with the forces that we have initially right now. And of course, just in case you want to reread this, that's fine about the intelligence report and Russia and all that. And of course, I did went ahead to make several alliances, so at this moment though, might as well just get these forces to here. Not all of them. I will have them stay here. I will have some of these units reach toward here as quickly as they can, and several of these units towards here as well, and entrench. Also, we have several treaties that I forgot to do, which are the ones that we are already allied, but I'm going to go with the ones that are, how should I say this, very likely to get conquered, as I'm sure you may all kind of remember what happened in the original LP, including my Italy Let's Play. But let's just get this started and get ready. And Bulgaria is already attacked by Turkey, of course. And we're going to get a lot of alliances. Available unit construction, go ahead, build whatever you want. Research on your hand. And of course, Germany goes to war rather quickly. It's kind of to be expected. But with that, I forgot, unfortunately for this restart right now, that I realized I completely forgot to put some garrisons, which is going to be a mistake. So I gotta put these garrisons. I have to hold the line. Send the Air Force, whatever I have, to deal with the heaviest fighting. And already three nations are gone. Thailand's been conquered. Will they conquer Myanmar like last time? I don't know, but we're just gonna have to wait and see. Remove all these messages, including the diplomatic ones, and already start researching. But I don't want these. Actually, for tanks, we'll go with this. But for warfare, we're gonna need. Let's get this just for a little bit more firepower. And here's the Turkish invasion. Now let's just get a little bit more forces to the front lines as best as possible. But it's quite a lot of units. Have to point out to put full garrisons everywhere. And the Germans are just gonna push through rather quickly. Defenses by Germany, of course. It's pretty obvious. Although, when it comes to the idea of going to war immediately, I have doubts that it could work anyway. So, even when that happens, that we try to just go to war immediately, if it turns out that the Germans already deployed their army rather quickly and they'll easily just push us back and we haven't made progress in the 30 or so minutes, that's pretty much it. It pretty much shows that might show that it's impossible to outright conquer Germany rather quickly. Alright, now we're just going to deal with the defense. And Belgium's been conquered. And I'm going to have to put all the garrisons by the capital, so that it won't fall rather easily. But I am going to get some garrisons down here, because I know the Czech Republic could fall at any moment, especially if the Germans decide to just advance a lot more quickly than usual if they wanted to, so this will be kind of one defensive line I have to worry about. So I got those, except for these garrisons and these mines, which I'll also put garrisons to hold. Same with this town, same with this town, which has no garrisons, and actually, can you please increase garrisons? Just let her do it. And now, looks like we're going to be under attack here, unless we do something. But, yeah, it looks like the Czech Republic's not going to last long. And with that, France is gone as well. Completely conquered, with Italy not at all invading, but Switzerland this time is under attack again. I'm saying again when it comes to the Italy let's play. But anyway, I gotta get one of my tanks over here, and another one over here, just in case. And yes, I know we're running out of supplies, but that's to be expected, because we really don't quite have the time to actually build anything, let alone the resources. And Belarus is invading, and we don't have any armies over here, so there's no point of that. Let's check the rest of the world quickly. Second Korean War, no surprise. Is Mongolia, yep, they're under attack by Russia. Not China, not really. Okay, hold on, pause. Quickly pause and start making land grab. Deploy garrisons. Will you get over here? Or here, actually. Okay, deploy garrisons. Deploy garrisons. Get over here if you want to, or whatever. Remove all these messages. Have somebody get over here and deal with these garrisons, please. And hopefully that will not be deployed. But we just lost our position here. And strangely, I don't know why there are no garrisons. And the Germans have stopped attacking here. Wait. Is it possible? What forces do we have? Okay, we have a damaged T-54. Okay, let's see if we can try. Let's see if we can try to push toward Berlin. Probably will not work. We don't have much of an air force anymore. Most of which is damaged. And non-existent. Yeah, that didn't go well. Oh! Who declared war? Of course, Serbia. Okay, Turkey is expanding into Georgia, is invading Armenia, is invading Iran, unless they will once again conquer like last time, the original first episode of this LP. But it doesn't look like Bulgaria is gonna fall soon. Switzerland has fallen. Is Italy at war yet? No. But this position is lost. And our forces' attempt to invade Berlin has completely failed. And so on and so forth, with Belarus having conquered its neighbor. Vietnam is not at war with Myanmar yet, but they are at war with Greater Malaysia and India. Not really much change going on here in the new Korean War. Mongolia is not going to last long. Okay, Syria is getting invaded. And the usual of what's going on. Actually, what's the info about Germany? The typical description, even in the regular kind of game modes. And right now, this position is being lost. I'm surprised the Netherlands has survived this long, despite their capital being surrounded and by sea as well. I don't see the Germans ever deploying landing ships or anything for that matter to land anywhere. Although they're attacking Norway, Denmark, can we make an alliance? I guess we can. Might be a bit of a risk for them, but we could use another ally, maybe even another front, as a sacrifice. No offense. Okay, Austria, you're not at war yet, but Germany could just outright invade in a moment. Italy's not at war yet. Serbia is slowly heading toward Bosnia's capital. Although, are they at war with somebody else? Yep, Germany and Turkey. So sadly, they're going to be at war with Turkey once Bulgaria falls. And I don't see that. I really don't see Serbia surviving. Ukraine. Okay, we need to get these. Okay. Austria is now under attack. Slovenia. Croatia. Just gotta get more of these mutual defense packs. Romania. Moldova. Latvia. Estonia. And Finland. Yeah, we already, yeah, we got Finland. Yes, yes, yes. Go ahead, deploy units in wherever it is. And I just realized I should have been building those land fabrications I did a while back in the original. Yeah, first episode. And what do you want, Sudan? I suppose, okay.
We need reinforcements.
Syria is gone. Iran looks like this time might actually survive. Not so sure about Armenia, or Georgia for that matter. The Georgia Republic. And is there any changes in the rest of the world, like North America? No, same thing. They're allies with Canada and Mexico, so no manifest destiny scenario. Brazil hasn't invaded anybody yet. Myanmar is now at war with Vietnam, but how long will that last? Mongolia, uh-oh. Okay. Mongolia's not gonna last. Kazakhstan is at war with China. Don't know why. But in the meantime, though, we are losing so much land now. If I could just get more of these. Declare war on who? Of course. My navy only has transports. Okay, and I got a frigate. Probably not gonna be much. Netherlands is still holding, but looks like it's not gonna be for a while. Huh? Oh, great. Okay, so Mongolia is completely conquered by Russia. And Belarus is invading Ukraine, or who declared war? Oh, Ukraine declared war. Alright. Although, I don't understand why there's a bit of a focal point will be here when there's a bridge over here. At... what is this? Mazer? Or Mazer? I don't know. I gotta get more units to retreat. I got full garrisons here, so this area is secure, but the center and the north, not really, and the Netherlands has finally fallen. And that means, oh yeah, these are under UK control. Okay. Not much. Bulgaria has been conquered. Yeah. Slightly divided by Serbia and Turkey. Greece is now in the war. Oh, Oh, so finally this time, South Africa has conquered Mozambique. Great. Wait, does that mean Rhodesia is gonna fall? And what about Namibia? Well, I guess that'd be interesting to see South Africa actually doing a decent progress on their end.
We need reinforcements.
Yes, I know. Just gonna take a quick look. There he is. Declared war on Nigeria and South Africa. Right. Mongolia is at Madagascar. Or I don't know why I said Mongolia. Is at war with South Africa. Portugal is allies with Spain and Italy. Is Italy at war? No. Now I gotta check Ukraine for a bit. Okay, they're losing a bit of land there. And we're losing more land rather quickly. We're trying to deploy as many as I can, let alone building units. Let's see, some three tanks, two engineers, and a mobile radar. It's not enough. Oh, these are intelligence academy. I'm such an idiot. I am a complete idiot. I said land fabrications, not intelligence academy. How did I make that mistake? And I gotta wait for another day before these two are gone. And that delay screwed me over. Commodity shortages, I know. Industrial, goods, military. Very expensive, however. So only three at the moment. And now those intelligence academies are gone. These are now finally, after a delay, gonna be built. Denmark is under attack. Okay. Belarus is still at war with Ukraine. Nothing I can do here. Nothing I can do. I have a few troops, but all I have is a single infantry type unit that's heavily damaged. Serbia hasn't conquered Bosnia for some reason. And navy construction, I don't know, see the point, but you know, I guess I got no choice. Greece is holding out. Jeez. Defenses, okay. Full garrisons here. And a lot more here in this area. Deploy some of these ore mines. Deploy here. Deploy one over at Pluck. Another at Wolokawik. I really can't pronounce how that's really called. So I apologize if I butchered it, which I know I might have. Torun. This place. Here, and here. I don't know about Belarus, though. We have a causability against them, but they also have a causability, though our relations are somewhat cool. But just in case, I'm gonna start deploying a lot of garrisons, even one by Ukraine. Just in case. Just in case if Belarus out of nowhere decides to invade us. Okay, guess that's... okay, not fully enough. You. I'm gonna leave alone. Okay, is Denmark doing well? Looks like they are. The Germans are too focused on us. Too focused over here. They're not invading Italy yet. It's a bit surprising. And they're certainly not invading Spain. Which is a bit odd that they wouldn't go to Spain, and right now, not against Italy. I'm just gonna do what I gotta do. Just keep deploying more and more garrisons. A lot. And hopefully get these built up quickly, but that's asking a bit too much. That's asking much, don't you think? Okay, military goods. And with that, let's check the rest of the world, and I'm just gonna reluctantly buy a bond. Whatever. Myanmar is okay. India is expanding and losing territory at the same time. China. A war of Kazakhstan. You'd be a bit surprised again if the Philippines falls. But still. Who else is Russia at war with? Tajikistan, Myanmar, Turkmenistan, and Uzbekistan. Alright. And North Korea only has China and Vietnam as allies. Eh. Kazakhstan is still holding. Iran this time is holding. Israel, whoa. Okay, that's an impressive sight, though how long will that last? Probably not long. I know I might have jinxed it for Israel, but what do you expect? No matter what, they just can't seem to conquer anything for that matter. The AI, at least. And Austria is gonna fall. Slovakia is gonna last long. That means we're gonna have to deal with another front here. That I forgot to put some more garrisons. Here, no garrisons here. Another one. You. And you. And I guess that should be it. And the southern front is actually secured. As the Germans are focusing on Hungary and other nations. Still don't see why Serbia failed to conquer Bosnia. There's really nothing to do. Other than just wait. Oh, God, you gotta be kidding. The Philippines has fallen by what? Is my question. Austria falls. Who else is trying to declare war? Oh, Indonesia. But seriously, how the hell did the Philippines fall? Is really the question I have. Well, there's what they just do. Surrender rather quickly? I don't know. Okay, this village is lost. I'm gonna deploy even more garrisons here. Full garrisons here that should have been deployed. And I don't have much of an army anymore. Most of which is just garrisons. And I have a T-54 that's damaged. And it's being chased. At least the garrisons are at least holding up, but how much supplies do they have? Yeah, the ease is gonna replace that for now. Also, not possible to make peace. Great. Okay, Slovenia's next. And Italy is still not under attack. And Portugal has somehow got this island. That makes no sense. Spain, maybe. Germany, maybe. Italy, I guess obvious. But Portugal? Portugal? It's just the usual silliness of territorial changes. And Warsaw is getting dangerously close to being under attack. I got a BMP, so I'm just gonna send him out, being sacrificed. And send the remain what's left of my air force, just 3 planes. Now, back in South Africa, doesn't look like they're taking advantage of their new territory to just expand or even conquer Rhodesia yet. Not attacking Madagascar. Not really much going on. Oh, and Nigeria's expansion. Which could result in Niger being conquered, and Ghana, and likely Cameroon, who is under attack by... Oh, wait. Never mind.
We need reinforcements.
Okay, our capital's getting dangerously close. Dangerously getting close to being conquered. And these facilities are not going to be done anytime soon. At all. But military goods are not going to be finished anytime soon. Oh boy. We have so many allies, but it's not going to be enough. The United States is not going to declare war on Germany. Same with most of the nations in North America and South America, as an exception, I guess. And sure enough, Brazil has begun invading its neighbors. Uruguay looks like it's going to fall. Paraguay is okay. And so on and so forth, and Slovenia is conquered. Right. There's nothing I can do. Anyway, what's going on with Ukraine? Why are you not counterattacking Belarus? I don't get it. Israel, yep, I knew it. They lost this territory. And what supplies do they have anyway? Not much military, not much in everything, and the fact that, if I recall, there are no coal deposits anywhere in the Middle East. With the exception in Iran, but that's kind of it. Yeah, the only closest is all the way in Ethiopia, and Slovakia has fallen. Right. Well, looks like this could be the beginning of the end. We're now doing another front, with Ukraine helping out a little bit. And with them gaining a bit of that territory for their own. Will they take this town? Oh, come on, America. I want units, not missiles. We don't have much money anyway, so I'm just gonna just accept. Ukraine, you can just advance north. Thank you. I'm not gonna send any units if I have any to try and take these lands. There's really no point. But it looks like they might be in trouble. But Ukrainian reinforcements are here, at least in this front. Okay, this village is lost. This one, re-garrison for additional troops. I don't have a navy anymore, most of which is just sunk, and all I have is just these useless transports. Denmark is surprisingly holding out. What if the Germans making some rather odd decisions? Why are they just saying their navy when they could have just used their army to cross these bridges? I don't know. Okay, I got a MiG, but it's not gonna be much. I could send them out here and help. Okay, that probably would have been much better if I'd done it earlier. Oh god, that's a lot of leopards. And I see a leopard one. I could have sworn I saw... Yep, there's a leopard one. And we're under attack from the south. I'm hoping we're not attacked from the other side, from the east, which will obviously be Belarus. Although the front here is quiet. Yeah, I don't have any mobile units. All I have are a few ships and lots of garrisons, so I'm screwed. But I'm gonna stop here because I'm running out of time. and so on and so forth. Oh god. Well, I hope you enjoyed this. I tried to defend and this and all that, but it just doesn't seem possible right now. I'm just gonna continue on, see how long we can last. Maybe if the Germans actually run out of steam, then maybe in the long run we'll counterattack. If not, then it's at least we gave it a try. But I hope you enjoyed this, and see you again in the next episode. And also to properly save. So, see you then.